I will agree with Mark, though. I mean, I have much more confidence in the Senate investigation. They also have subpoena power. And then, of course, let's not forget there's an FBI investigation, which it does not have to, you know, align around politics, which, a lot, you know, with 100 agents, that's a lot of agents looking into this information. So the House will continue, and it will, unfortunately, I think, just given what Nunes did this week, be difficult to take seriously. But there's another piece that came out today that Nunes said, which for me was the jaw-dropper, when he said that now Carter Page, Manafort, and Roger Stone are all agreeing to talk somewhere, sometime, to the committee. That may seem interesting. It's not that interesting to me because I don't think they'll be under oath. But the name that's not mentioned is the name I mention often on the show, Mike Flynn, the former national security advisor. It is starting to look like, from my sources and then also from open reporting, that Mike Flynn is the one who may have a deal with the FBI, and that's why we have not heard from him for some time.
Can I ask
if
you
that
something?
Is true, this...
Go yeah. on, go on. Finish your thought. Let her finish. Finish your thought.
No, if that is true, and it's just one has to look at, there's four names and three of them are willing to talk voluntarily. So, but if that is true, then there is someone who was high up in the team. He wasn't a mere volunteer and was the national security advisor for some time, whose dealings with Turkey at one stage and then, of course, with Russia have come under suspicion. And as I've said before on the show with Jason and others, there's a lot of dots. I am not at collusion yet. I am, you know, but on a scale from 0 to 10, it's hard to be anywhere under 6 at this stage.